Well, this is Daz from Thailand Wild. We've just had about a 5 hour, excuse me, I'm pretty tired, about a 5 hour hike into some forest here in Phitsanulok province in Thailand. And we had to cross the river several times. We were in and out of water, and then we thought we were gonna get rained on, a big thunderstorm whipped up over the hills, but we've been lucky and we've got to where we're gonna stay now. So I'm just going to start exploring around this area and see what I can find.
This is the Nan River that flows through this forest. And just downstream from where we are now was where the Siamese crocodiles were rediscovered. I say rediscovered with caution because the villagers apparently always knew they were there. But some were found here about 8 or 9 years ago when there was a lot of rain one year. And they've been found several times since.
Actually, there's a lovely flat ledge of rock here up above the river. Great view looking down. I think if it was the winter season, the dry season, this would be a terrific place to set up a camp. I'll remember that. Maybe come to stay here again in a couple of months' time.
I found this fallen tree. These always interest me, of course. This is going to become part of the ecosystem as this thing rots away. Insects will be able to live in it. And as it falls to the ground, all manner of animals might be able to live underneath it. Of course, we were waiting for it to get dark so we could go out exploring for reptiles and amphibians. But in the meantime, there was a lovely collection of butterflies close to the camp. We can see various nawabs here. The Indian yellow nawab, quite a few of those. That's the one here. We can see 3 or 4 individuals with a lovely light green patch on the wing. There are also, behind the Nawabs, there's some yellow Rajas. And just flying into the picture now, here it comes, settling in amongst the others, a common Nawab. We can see that with the smaller yellow spot up above the main patch. After dark, we headed out with the lights. One of the first things that I came across was this spider. I've seen many wacky shaped spiders here over the years. This one is quite interesting. It's quite a large body there of a very peculiar shape. And just doing that thing, that one of those wonders of nature, spinning its web here with such precision. Absolutely delightful to watch this. The kind of thing you can just so easily overlook. But when you stop and really study what this thing is doing, it's phenomenal. And then almost immediately, a snake. Fantastic. Really, really hoping to find some around this area tonight. And this was the first one, a Laotian wolf snake. I mean, it's an unfortunate thing, of course, that these nocturnal animals are going to be disturbed when we put the lights on them. But at least we can get a look at them, just film for a few moments. This one had been poking around in holes here, looking for food. During the night, we found several Chinese swimming scorpions. This is an interesting species to me. I've seen quite a lot of debate online about this one, various people having been stung. I've been stung many times. But not being badly affected by this. I must say, I do not know what these beautiful little insects are. If anyone has ideas on this, please leave a comment below. They were all just stuck together on one stem. Again, the scorpion there. I came back to it several times, hoping that we might see it catching or eating something, but it didn't happen. somewhat more fearsome for me. This wasp's nest, you would not want to blunder into that in the dark. Luckily, one of the other people that I'm here with saw this first. Again, I've been stung by these things before, and I did not enjoy that at all. A little agama, resting up on a branch, just trying to keep out of everybody's way, see it through another night. This one's a garden fence lizard, Colotes versicolor. And then a lovely tree frog. Look at the colors on this one. Gorgeous. This is the common tree frog, fairly widespread. Many people may have found these in their gardens. You can see a little bit of a black stripe there behind the eye. We often come across these very large millipedes, especially in the wetter parts of the forest. This one maybe only about 15 centimeters perhaps, not particularly huge. In another location not far from here, we found some absolute whoppers a couple of months ago, getting on to almost 30 centimeters in length. And then a wonderful common wolf snake, the biggest I've ever seen. I'm here with my friend Alex, and I'm going to leave you with the audio that we recorded at the time as we tried to get some film of this snake.
You might have to move back though in a minute, because otherwise if it comes your way you're going to be in the shot. I just let it go out if it does move. Up this tree root. How long would you say that is, Alex? It was stretched out. It looked like it could be like 90 centimeters.
90,
maybe even a
meter. Yeah, it would be wild.
Yeah.
From the marks that we saw this snake on the ground, we were able to estimate the length later as 80 centimeters.
Yeah, that's good. Anything like that. All right, so I'm going to get it as it comes out past this tree.
Yeah.
And if you can get the light into that. Next, I'll keep it in. Look at that. Put this west side up to 30 again. 25. I'm just guessing on the focus here though. Running on that and just go through the shot. Okay, that's awesome.
Then Alex has done it again. A couple of months ago, he found one of these beautiful little frogs, one of the first records in Thailand of this South Vietnamese bug-eyed frog. Quite incredible that he's found another one here, as very few locations known in Thailand so far. Well, that's where I slept last night. There's a little bit of a rocky ledge here, not really a cave as such, but at least I was inside there a little bit. I was afraid there might be rain in the night, but there wasn't. So now we've woken up to a lovely morning, and our wet clothes that were on the side of the river hanging on bushes have attracted some beautiful moths and butterflies. I actually don't know what this species is. Somebody please leave a comment and let me know. But just downstream, close to where I was sleeping, there was an area of rock with some water flowing out from the forest. And if that water has minerals or anything, some salts that butterflies like, this is what happens. And we've got a lovely collection of them here. Various nawabs here and rajas again, mostly the yellow raja. Four different kinds of nawab I've seen in this area here feeding this morning. Again, the Indian yellow nawab with the larger single patch. The yellow raja again. Look at the proboscis down there on the ground looking for something. And here we see a jeweled nawab coming into shot. Also probing onto the rock, trying to pick up something there. It's a shame about the shadow from my camera. I'm using a gimbal here for the first time, and I learnt an awful lot about how to use and how not to use a gimbal on this trip. Well, the water has gone down somewhat in the night. I was very relieved to see that this morning, so it's going to make the journey back and the crossing of the river a little bit easier. And so that was pretty well it for this short trip. Can't wait to come back here again.